Hey my lovelies, welcome back to my channel. Love to see you here. I hope you're having a wonderful day today as well. So today's topic will be for one of the most popular diets in 2021 that people are following. It's very popular to follow it, but is it that easy to maintain? So let's talk about that today. Let's begin with ketogenic diet. The ketogenic diet, also called keto diet, is a very low carb based and high in fats based diet. Keto diet offers many health benefits, but it's one of the tougher ones because you have to dramatically decrease your carb intake, so get rid of bread and all carbs that you're consuming throughout the day and increase your fat intake. So during this diet, your body will use fats instead of carbs for the fuel. So you will have a lot of energy as well, so you don't need to worry about that. But the biggest benefit of that is that you will be losing weight without worrying about calories as much. During this diet, you can eat a lot of seafood, vegetables, especially avocados, because they have loads of healthy fats, meat, poultry, eggs, and specifically cheese as well. So that's a benefit of it. I did try the keto diet when I was doing my year abroad in the States. And what happened was I was working out once a day, but every single day, and I would go to get a meal and I would eat a lot of meat, some olive oil on the side with some spinach and a lot of vegetables. I did lose weight dramatically. I don't remember when I was as skinny and felt as healthy as at any other time before. So I was super energized. I was feeling healthy. I was never crashing, but it was really hard to say no to, let's say, chocolate chip cookies or some sundaes. So it's a hard one to follow, but if you go for it, then it's extremely beneficial because you will feel awesome after it, even though it's really hard to follow it. So keep this in mind, guys. Another diet that is very popular at the moment is carnivore diet. So this one is a quite extreme diet and I'm looking forward to try it this year. I believe I have a plan for my diet during second half of this year or something like that. I will definitely try it, but it will be very hard to do. So why carnivore diet is so extreme? Because it excludes every single thing that you eat throughout the day. Vegetables, fruits, nuts, you can't consume any of that. What you can eat with carnivore diet is only meat, poultry, and like some healthy oils like olive oil, and that's it. You have to be very strict, no snacks, nothing whatsoever. So this is pretty much meat-based diet. So for me, it's not a problem because I do eat meat, although to say no to some vegetables or fruits, I believe that this would be a bit harder, especially obviously some snack days. But I believe if you set your mind to it, you can do it. So this diet is so popular because it has anti-inflammatory benefit for your health. Studies have shown that this diet helped to relieve depression symptoms, as well as other people who had autoimmune conditions as well. So I do not have those problems myself, but I always wanted to try it because I heard that within 2 weeks you will feel extremely hungry because your organism will still want those carb intake and everything like that. Although once you get used to it, it has a benefit that you will be able to focus extremely well, which will help you with your work, studies, whatever you're doing. So I want to try it. I know that this will be quite extreme for me as well, but I'm looking forward to it. And I think down the line, I will do another video to see, to review this diet, how did it go, how I felt, and yeah, see what it does to me. With that being said, if you are a meat eater and you want to go to some diet like this, I would say start with ketogenic diet at first, because carnivore is pretty hard to just jump into. So go for ketogenic one because it's not as extreme. See how you feel after a few months and then maybe try carnivore, because like I said, if you will just switch like that, it might be a little bit too extreme. The next diet is paleo diet. So paleo diet is a diet where you follow a plan to eat foods of hunter-gatherers time era, Paleolithic era, which started 2.5 million years ago to 10,000 years ago. So this is focusing on between those times when our hunter-gatherers ate during those times, what was actually naturally gathered from the nature. So this diet would normally include loads of lean meats, fish, seeds, nuts, fruits, berries, vegetables, everything that you could hunt, gather, or find in the nature. The benefit of this diet is either to lose or maintain healthy weight, to get more tolerant when it comes to appetite control, and to tolerate glucose intake as well. I believe that this diet is one of the easiest diet to follow so far, because you don't need to get rid of too many things at once, although you need to get rid of snacks and stuff like that. Although you do have a chance to eat most of the things that you actually like. So I believe it's a good start, especially if you just want to shift your meal plans, your daily consumption of foods that should be a bit more healthy. If you want to follow something healthier, shift there. So I would say that this paleo diet is one of the best ones to begin with, because it's not as dramatic, but it's really, really good for you. Another diet is Mediterranean diet. So that's the diet where people used to eat in Italy or Greece or countries like that back in 1960s. So this diet is high in vegetables, fruits, nuts, legumes, seeds. If you like hummus, this is for you. I love hummus. And this diet can prevent heart attacks, strokes, type 2 diabetes. So this diet is extremely good, especially if you like Italian or Greek food. Well done for you. You can follow this diet with no questions asked. Okay, so now one of the biggest questions are, out of these popular diets, which one should I choose? What to do? Which direction to go to? So I would say track your body language. Like I mentioned in previous videos, you have to understand your body first. Write down what are your favorite meals. What do you really, really like to eat throughout the day, apart from snacks and sugar, right? So, and see which diet requires you to get rid of which food. So basically then it will be easier for you to define if something would say you can't really live without hummus, right? And you want to keep it, then go for a Mediterranean diet. So basically you just have to check what you really like, what you can get rid of, and start with that. Because if you will go to a very drastic one, dramatic diet, then it will be just really, really hard for you at first. And then you might just drop it within a month or two because you will be craving stuff at first. So I would say start small and continue growing like that. Check what your body is telling you. Track your body language, write it down how you feel, and see how it goes. I think that's the best way to see which diet suits us and how we feel by having it. We don't have to get rid of everything from our lives because it's extremely hard and we all know it. We can follow a healthier diet by not getting rid of stuff that we actually really truly love. So I really hope that you enjoyed my video today. I definitely enjoy speaking to you guys. So if you like this video, give a cheeky thumbs up today, and don't forget to subscribe and share some love in comments below. Thank you so much and have a wonderful day, you guys.